Yes, that's right, Badgerteers. It's less than a week till Christmas, pretty much. I hope you've got all your presents. Because the Badger has... Still, I'm sure there'll be plenty of time. Epic fail, Badgerteers and Badgerettes. But that's not why we're here. Perhaps I'll do a blog about the pressures of Christmas shopping if the Badger gets a chance. Today, we're here to discuss the Badger's top 5 Christmas movies! That's right, Badgerteers and Badgerettes. So without further ado, Chumley Warners, let's start with number 5. Number 5 is Elf, the Will Ferrell Christmas movie. And trust me, Badgerteers and Badgerettes, this is probably the third time I've seen this, so this is a new one to the list of the Badger's favourites. It's just something about this film where the baby gets taken in by Santa, adopted and looked after the elves, and then he realises about his father and the fact that he's human, but yet he tries to rediscover and spread the Christmas cheer to everyone. There's something about that. And the fact that he always finds love, and it's almost like it's sugarcoating the real world in a little way, but then it's sort of saying, you know, the Christmas cheer and the happiness is here, but we just need to find it. And Badgerteers and Badgerettes, if you haven't found Christmas cheer yet, please try and watch some of these films, and I'm sure they will cheer you up. Elf is definitely an awesome film, and it's the 5th one on the Badger's list. Perhaps next year it will rise up, but this is only the 3rd time I've seen this film, but I do love it. Number 4, A Nightmare Before Christmas. This Tim Burton vehicle is fantastic with Jack Skellington. It's just a great holiday film, and it's fantastic the way you can watch it from October to Christmas with it still being relevant. And I love all the animation and the excitement in it, and the fact that Jack has to find out that there's new holidays apart from Halloween, and he broadens his horizons, enters the real world, Tim Burton verse, and it's just really awesome, you know. And the fact that, I don't know, it's just got such a warm feeling to it in a way, you know. This is Halloween, and all that sort of stuff, but it's gory, grotesque, miserable, but happy. And it's such a weird mixture of music and fun. And trust me, Badgerteers and Badgerettes, The Nightmare Before Christmas is fantastic. And I went in the Disney store ages ago, a couple of years ago, Badgerteers, and I found this really nice sort of wrapping paper that really was cool for Nightmare Before Christmas, but I can't find it now. So I don't know if they still make it or it's a limited edition, but the boss loved it when I wrapped all her presents up in Nightmare Before Christmas wrapping paper. So it's just a really sort of festive treat of a film. Gory, grotesque, and fun. So it really sparks off the Badger's amusement. So that is a definite number 4 on the Badger's number 5 top 5 Christmas films. Number 3, Home Alone. I mean, for goodness sake, Macaulay Culkin, aka Kevin McAllister, gets lost in his own house when his parents leave him. It's totally plausible. All 8 of them forget about him. You know, he's such a sweet little boy. How can they not love him and want him on their trip? Come on, they say they do, but they all forgot about him. And none of them rushed back. Only the mum. They all just stayed there, didn't they? And all the fun hijinks, all the traps, all the silliness, all the stuff with Joe Pesci, and it's just really cool. I love all the traps and the silliness that he gets up to try and survive and outlive the robbers, those evil wet bandits. So yeah, Home Alone's a classic. I think I must have watched it maybe 20 times. You know, the bit with the aftershave, classic. Yeah, there's so many good things going on in that film. And there's always something new you notice. I've always found that each time I watch it, it's almost like there's something new added extra. So there's always something new that you go, oh yeah, I didn't see that in the background before. It's well worth watching it a billion times. So that makes number 3 on the Badger's list. Now, an interesting choice for the Badger. Number 2, Batman Returns. Da, 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 da. Yes, Badgerteers and Badgerettes, the upsetting story of the Penguin in the first 5 minutes, the cool music by Danny Elfman, the direction by, of course, Tim Burton, Michael Keaton as Batman, Danny DeVito as the Penguin, and the immortal and very sexy Michelle Pfeiffer as Catwoman. Now come on, if that's not a recipe for a decent, awesome film, I don't know what is. And then add Christmas in, and grotesque, evil stuff that old Christopher Walken gets up to, the awesome stuff that Catwoman does, you know, slightly different from the comic book, but a real sort of macabre edge. It's fantastic the way Batman and of course Michael Keaton and Michelle Pfeiffer play off each other in there, in the ballroom with the mistletoe. So there's romance, there's dark gothic romance, there's action, there's an adventure. It's just a really awesome film. So if you've never seen Batman Returns before, that is a great film on the Badger's list of top 5 Christmas films, because there's just something about it that's a good balance between enjoyable family fun, and this is a bit darker, and of course you get to see Michael Keaton as Batman, one of my favourite Batmans, and it's just so awesome. Yes, so Batman Returns is a fantastic film, action-packed, gory, dark. If you like that sort of thing, please check it out. Now, number 1 on the Badger's top 5 Christmas films list would have to be Muppet Christmas Carol. So yeah, number 1 on the list is Muppet's Christmas Carol. Now, this one by Jim Henson is a fantastic retelling of course, the Scrooge tale. So Scrooge ends up, sort of Michael Caine has the usual stuff where he's visited by the spirits, but there's lots of Muppet action going on, there's lots of in-jokes, lots of really cute fun, and of course I really think they nailed Tiny Tim in this. There's a bit of me, when I've had a few whiskies, I will start crying over this film. There's something about Muppet Christmas Carol that really makes it into a tearjerker for me. Does that make me a silly soppy badger at Christmas? More than likely it does. But the way Kermit reacts, the way Gonzo and Razzo are the narrators, there's just something really special about this film. And if you see the slight uncut version that is around, it is slightly darker, and they did cut it a little, I think, Disney, for children. But there's some real dark stuff with the last spirit, and it does make you think, more than you would actually like to think about it, it does sort of hit home on some points about Christmas. So yeah, there's just something about the songs, the uplifting tone, Fozzie Wigs, Rubber Chicken Factory, I mean, come on. There's so many silly points to it that really uplift me, and there's so many sort of like notes to it. The way you see Scrooge fall out with his potential wife, and he loses the love of his life, and that's sort of why he turns into the way he does, sort of means a lot really in a way. It just that means that don't let love rule your life in a way, obviously, but don't let it upset you. You know, if things go wrong, move on and find the special person. And that's what Scrooge manages to do in the end. He manages to realise that love and happiness and spreading the world of good is awesome. So don't let things upset you at Christmas. Move on and enjoy the festive season. That's what I would say. So that's why it is my number 1 fantastically Christmas film. So, what other films do you think there would be, Badgerteers? What films would be in your list? Please comment below. Now, there's an honourable mention. Die Hard, of course, a fantastic film. A lot of people will say that it's not Christmas until you see the bad guy falling off the tower to oblivion, and of course, Bruce Willis kicking some serious butt barefoot. So, maybe that's an honourable mention to the list, and of course, an unmemorable mention is Frozen. Frozen. I've only, you know, that film. a couple of years, I've probably had to watch it 40 times!
Ah!
If I have to watch it at Christmas, I'm gonna need to be drunk, okay? Very, very drunk.
Ah!
I hope you enjoyed my top 5 list, Badgerteers and Badgerettes. Remember, comment below your top 5 Christmas films. Bye for now, Chumley Warners. Bye for now, Badgerteers and Badgerettes. And if I don't see you, have a smashingly, spiffingly awesome Christmas. Ciao, amigos. Bye.
Hey guys, please remember that Badger's Beard Off is still running and will be running until the 30th of January. So if you haven't had a chance to look at the video or donate, please feel free to do both. That'd be fantastic. And remember, if you want to see the Badger shave his beard off, please donate. Bye for now, Badgerteers and Badgerettes. Bye.